Say also, no, what you're doing.
This is a motorboat. It is a boat which runs with boat.
Go ahead.
So basically, this is a boat which runs by motors, and these are paddles. With they push the water in order to move. So right now, this is pushing the water ahead, so this will go back. As this is going in this direction, which is the clockwise direction, it is pushing water ahead, so the boat will go backwards. And then this is pushing the water behind, which is anti-clockwise, and then then the boat will move forward. Same will happen with this. Now to turn it, think of it like this. If this is moving, if this is pushing water backwards, so the water is being pushed backwards.
Just a second, Tatiksh. Which part is forward and backward? So that is not clear here.
Okay. So this is pushing water backwards, so this will move forward, right? But now if this paddle is pushing water upwards, so this is trying to move backwards. So now think, this is going upwards, this is going backwards. Well, you can't just extend the boat. Non-realistic. Well, it is realistic, but. So this will slightly turn this side, and the back will go like this. Same will happen if it is reversed. If this paddle is pushing water behind, this should go forward, right? And if this is pushing water ahead, it should go backwards, and the result will be this turning over here, the back half will turning over here, and the front half turning over here. Thus, the boat will turn. Any questions? Okay.
Now. I have. So this is amazing what you said. If the water is pushed in one direction, why the boat will go in the other direction?
So think about it like this way. Motion is in respect with it is comparable. So right now if the water is going backwards, like this is pushing it backwards. So you can think about it this way. The water is going backwards, but in respect to the water, the boat is going forward.
If you will turn one pedal clockwise, so it will while you will move other pedal, it can move it this side also and this side also.
Yes, that is also correct. But just to make the motion faster, I have used both. Because this will be for the side.
Yeah, clockwise or anti-clockwise के बारे में थोड़ा सा clarity दे दूँ. तुम लोग इन दोनों को बहुत ही लिबरली यूज करते हो वर्ड को. क्लॉकवाइज एंटी क्लॉकवाइज का सेंस तब बनता है जब आप ये बताओ कि आप रोटेटिंग चीज को किस तरफ से देख रहे हो. अगर ये चीज ऐसे रोटेट हो रही है तो तुम्हारे लिए अभी क्लॉकवाइज है एंटी क्लॉकवाइज है. मेरे लिए क्लॉकवाइज है इधर से. जब तक ये नहीं बताओगे ना किधर से देख रहे हो, क्लॉकवाइज एंटी क्लॉकवाइज का कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, कोई सेंस ही नहीं. बताओगे नहीं कि किधर से देख रहे हो. सब लोग यूज करते हैं इसको वर्ड को. Because they want to say opposite direction.
Just like left and right.
So everybody's trying to say the opposite direction when they say clockwise, anti-clockwise. So say opposite direction, yeah, opposite direction of rotation. Varna anti-clockwise, clockwise, you have to fix the point of view. Ki main is point of view se baar baar ye cheez bol raha hu. Otherwise it won't make sense. Okay. Dusra, I did not understand the relative motion thing when you were explaining why boat will move in the other direction.
So motion, the term motion is respective to the other objects. So like if this is a car, okay, it's pretty kind, but anyway, and this is a, if this car is moving forward, the car is in in motion in respect to the train. But if here is another car and it's going parallel, that means same. So these both, the car is not in motion in respect to this, because it is being same. The distance between this is same. Whereas if this, the car moves forward in this, it is changing its position with respect to the train, as the train is not moving. Same goes to here. And in respect to the car, the train is moving.
The relative motion you're talking about, it's absolutely fantastic what you just said. I understand. What you're really talking about is frame of reference. Mm-hmm. From which reference point of view you are looking at the object. And that is true with respect to the water, boat is moving ahead. The question is, your action, who are a water tuber, why is that action leading to the movement of the boat?
It's not, you can think about it this way. The boat is actually not moving, like the tree.
Actually not moving.
Just like the tree.
Uh-huh.
But actually the water is moving. You can think about it this way. Water, just like the car. As you are pushing the water.
But the fact is, agar boat ye lake ke andar hai, तो वाटर बह के पीछे नहीं जा रहा होता, बोट आगे जा रही होती है. वाटर इज नॉट फ्लोइंग बैकवर्ड्स. लेक तो वहीं पर ही रहती है, पानी तो वहीं भरा रहता है. एक्चुअल में तो बोट ही मूव कर रही है ना. व्हाट यू आर सीइंग अगेन इज अ फ्रेम ऑफ रेफरेंस. तुम किस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से देख रहे हो? अगर दो कार्स है, ठीक है, दोनों कार्स ऐसे आमने सामने आ रही है, ये 5 से और ये 5 से, अगर तुम इसको 0 पे रख लेते हो और इसको 10 मान लेते हो, इज द सेम थिंग. कोलिजन वैसा ही होगा, सब कुछ मैथमेटिकली सब कुछ वैसा ही निकल के आएगा. ठीक है, बट फैक्ट भी तो है कि दोनों 5-5 पे आ रही थी. तो मैं जो हो रहा है उसकी बात कर रहा हूँ. रिलेटिवली तुम चीजों को ऐसे चेंज कर सकते हो कि हाँ ये 5-5 है तो मैं इसको 0 ले लेता हूँ, इसको 10 ले लेता हूँ, है ना. इट विल स्टिल बी रिलेटिवली द सेम थिंग, राइट. मगर मैं, द क्वेश्चन इज ऑन वॉट इज एक्चुअली हैपनिंग, कि वॉटर को पुश करके बोट आगे क्यों ही क्यों जाएगा, ये क्यों पॉसिबल है, ये बोल रहा हूँ मैं. तो मुझे इसको अलग पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से देखने के लिए बोल रहा हूँ. मैं बोल रहा हूँ अलग पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू एग्जिस्ट करता है इन आर हेड. एक्चुअल में तो बॉडी मूव कर रही है, उस पे आंसर करो.
सो इफ यू आर पुशिंग द वाटर बैकवर्ड्स, इट्स काइंड ऑफ कॉमन सेंस, बट
ये तुम्हें कॉमन सेंस लग रहा है और ये कॉमन सेंस ही है, बिकॉज यूनिवर्स वर्क्स लाइक दैट. आई जस्ट वांट यू टू से इट. What is that one thing we have observed about the universe, जिसकी वजह से हम चल पाते हैं, जिसकी वजह से कार आगे मूव करती है, जिसकी वजह से हर एक्चुअल में सारा मूवमेंट हो रहा है, कोई भी मूवमेंट उसी चीज की वजह से हो रहा है अल्टीमेटली. हाँ, of course it's force, but why that force? ऐसा भी तो हो सकता है कि बोट का पैडल घुमा, बस पानी पीछे फ्लिक हो गया, खत्म. Should stop there. पानी फ्लिक हो जाना चाहिए, बात यहीं खत्म हो जानी चाहिए. आगे क्यों बढ़ेगी बोट उसके कारण, है ना. वो भी तो कॉमन सेंस हो सकता है.
हाँ.
क्लिक हो गया हमारी टॉपिक तो, राइट. बट ऐसा नहीं हो रहा है, बोट आगे जा रही है, स्विमर आगे जाता है. क्यों जा रहा है, कैसे, व्हाई? रिसर्च वो किया है.
हाँ.
यू शुड नो.
सो व्हाई डज दिस बोट फ्लोट इन द फर्स्ट प्लेस? Because of this.
No, you did not answer the that thing. No, push wala. It's. तुमने पता नहीं research work. I mean, we discussed it also. I don't know, but when we push something, it pushes us back. No, this is one of the most fundamental discoveries we have made about the universe. There is no proof of it. It's a discovery that this is how it is happening. Whenever we push something, it pushes us back. If it is strong enough, hard enough. No, that is the same thing. तो जब तुम वॉक करते हो तब भी तुम यही कर रहे हो, जब बोट कर रही है वो भी यही कर रही है. तो राइट वाला पैडल, इफ इट इज पुशिंग वाटर डाउनवर्ड्स इन दिस केस इन दिस डायग्राम, इट गोना जनरेट, द बोट इज गोना गो इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन, सिंपली बिकॉज वाटर हैज अ मास, ऑब्जेक्ट विच हैज मास, इट्स गोना अप्लाई द सेम फोर्स फॉरवर्ड टू द बोट. सिंपली दैट इज हाउ दिस ऑल्सो हैपन. When I'm pushing this wall, I get a pushback. You cannot deny this pushback. तुम्हें feel होता है ये pushback, नहीं होता? हो होता है ना फील. श्योर इट वॉज आई डोंट नो ये तो मुझसे मिस कैसे हो गया. ठीक है.
सो व्हाई डज दिस बोट फ्लोट? वेल इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द आर्किमिडीज प्रिंसिपल.
नो इट इज नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ द आर्किमिडीज प्रिंसिपल. इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ सम डिस्कवरी व्हिच आर्किमिडीज मेड एंड नेम्ड इट आर्किमिडीज प्रिंसिपल.
एग्जैक्टली. सो
रब इट एंड रब इट एंड डिस्क्राइब द डिस्कवरी.
आई वाज गोना डू दैट आफ्टरवर्ड्स.
No, you can always say that this discovery was made by Archimedes, right? Anyways, ठीक है, sorry, I'll not interrupt whichever way you want.
So it wasn't on pause.
Continue.
हाँ.
Let me take.
So this thing floats because of an upward force called buoyancy. So the buoyancy force is exact, it's exactly equal to the water displaced by the object. So if you place something in water, it's going to displace some water obviously, right? Because it has mass and it's moving the mass to put it in there. So that the amount of water displaced, that creates an upward force which does not let the object sink. So now, if the buoyancy force is less than the force downwards, which is given by the object will sink, as the downward force is more than the upward force. But if the downward force is less than the upward force, it will float, as the upward force will cancel out the downward force and still has a force of its own. So it will sink. It will float. Got it?
That's correct. Correct enough. Yeah, what you're saying is right. Okay. Do you think that the same thing you can use to create a submarine?
Yes. So basically, a submarine. Well, one more thing.
No, but then a submarine doesn't just float, it controls the floating.
Hmm.
It sinks by itself, all by itself, willingly.
Hmm.
And it comes afloat willingly. Its more important job is to go underwater also. Hmm. Right?
Hmm. So basically what a submarine does is, a submarine, it displaces some water, but the mass of the submarine is less than the buoyancy force. But when it wants to sink, what it does is it collects some water. So it collects some water from the
inside,
yes, seas, ocean, whatever. It collects some water which increases its density, which causes it to sink. Got it? And now when it wants to come back, it just releases the water, which lowers the density, and it will come back up. So basically that's the principle used by.
But then don't you think when it is going down inside the water, you also have to account for the water pressure from all the directions, especially the water above you, because that has to be considered. Is that so? Okay, anyways, that's something different. But then there is this one question. While we are swimming, we are displacing the water.
Mm.
So that again, more buoyancy and you will be able to float.
Mm.
But then, wahi action karte hue, we go deep underwater also, doing the same thing, right? तब भी water displace कर रहे हैं, but हम फिर नीचे कैसे जा पा रहे हैं? Float क्यों नहीं कर रहे हैं? मतलब नीचे जा कैसे पा रहे हैं? Because ideally तो अगर मैं water displace कर रहा हूँ underwater भी, मुझे water तो displace करना ही पड़ता है, तो water displace कर रहा हूँ मैं underwater भी, मैं नीचे कैसे जा पाता हूँ? जिसको swimming आती है वो समझ रहा है मैं क्या कह रहा हूँ, देखा तो.
Right now when you go downwards, if you see when you're displacing water, you're actually pushing it upward in order to go downwards. Just like you told about now. So if you're pushing something backwards, it will give the same force back to you, but in the form of opposite.
But buoyancy is still working.
So
मतलब मैं जानबूझ के buoyancy को भी और cancel करने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ.
Yes. Because the density of the water is also.
I can just simply stop doing that, no?
If you stop doing this motion, you will come back up.
Because you're not pushing.
But then, if I do not need to move my hands in order to float, why do I need to swim? Because people do get, drowned, डूब जाती है ना. तुम बोल रहे हो कि मैं वापस ऊपर आ जाऊंगा, ठीक है, वो तुम्हें इंट्यूटिवली लग रहा है, नहीं होता ऐसा। जो वापस ऊपर आते हैं उनको पैर हिलाना पड़ता है, वाटर डिस्प्लेस करना पड़ता है, तब ऊपर आते हैं। लेकिन लोग डूबते हैं ना, आर बॉडीज डेंसिटीज आर मोर देन दी वाटर, हम डूबेंगे ही, ठीक है। तो फिर इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि अगर मैं अंडर वाटर हाथ चला रहा हूँ तो दैट मीन्स मुझे बायंसी को भी कैंसिल करना है, बिकॉज बायंसी इज कॉन्स्टेंटली पुशिंग मी आउट, ठीक है। वेयर इज दैट थिन लाइन, ये सोच के ऐसे समझ नहीं आ रहा होगा ना कि हम डूब सकते हैं कि हम तैर सकते हैं बिना एफर्ट के।
So basically, what I have like guessed, when you want to float right now, most people just spread out the body like this and then float because they're displacing more water. But if you, because even if the density is more of the body, you're displacing more water, which is given out of motion. So but if you're, when you actually want to sink, I think, I'm not sure, you can actually just straighten your body, which will cause you to sink as you're displacing less water. Maybe.
So there are two people, person A, person B. Person A and person B exactly same volume of water displaced कर रहे हैं body से, ठीक है। But जो person A है उसका जो साइज है इट्स बिकॉज ऑफ फैट इन हिज बॉडी, और पर्सन बी उसका जो साइज है इट्स बिकॉज ऑफ मसल इन हिज बॉडी, मसल उसका उस तरह का लार्ज है, बट वॉल्यूम ऑफ वाटर डिस्प्लेस बाय बोथ ऑफ देम इज द सेम। किसको कौन ज्यादा आसानी से तैर सकता है दोनों में से?
पर्सन बी मसल,
व्हाई? बिकॉज़ 1 ग्राम ऑफ 1 ग्राम ऑफ मास इज ये जो बोट है सो ये कितना मास अपने ऊपर उठा के फ्लोट करवा सकती है? अगर बोट डूब रही है तो तुम्हारा बैकअप प्लान क्या है?
नो, आई डोंट हैव अ बैकअप प्लान।
अब यू तुम डूबने दोगे?
दिस इज आई वुड
व्हाट ही इज ट्राइंग टू आस्क इज कैन यू डू समथिंग, कैन यू इमेजिन समथिंग डूइंग टू हेल्प योर बोट नॉट ड्राउन? मे
बी आई कुड मेक अ डिजाइन व्हिच कैन
लाइक टू द सेम बोट। नाउ यू कैन नॉट लाइक ना मैं टाइम को रोक देता हूं अभी डिजाइन को, सो बोट डूब रही है, व्हाट कैन यू डू? Because let's say वो डूब रही है because of the fact that it is not able to displace enough water or enough buoyancy.
Maybe I could extend the design a little bit, which could displace more.
So it should be extendable at run time. Run time पे extend हो सके।
I could design.
कैसे run time पे कैसे करोगे?
I would basically put I told you right in my right now project also. Which is controlled by spring over here.
Okay, sure.
And now these both parts, they could be connected by string to a motor. So like right now it will be like when the motor is moving, it will loosen the string, and slowly it will go outside because of the force by the spring. Right now this force of the spring was cancelled out by the force of the motor. And right now when the motor is loosening the string, it will slowly, slowly extend outwards. And same applies to this side.
और जैसे वो बलून जो वो होते हैं these rafts and life saving boats होती हैं वो generally those have air in filled inside them raft ही बोलते हैं उसको air भरी होती है have you not seen it just saying you can use balloons also no something which can hold air
so like when you're sinking
that is like the most efficient no come on there is automation for everything
oh so basically you're telling this to make it like a balloon size which
side mein ha
side side
tumne ha tumne wo dekha jo ferry pata hai kya hoti hai jo boats hoti hain jo normal locally chalti hain lakes mein aur rivers mein ferry unke side mein tires latke hue hote hain
so when you inflate those tires it will
nahi wo inflate nahi karte wo to isliye hote hain ki wo doob raha hai to usko tire fek ke de diya jaldi se aisa karke just saying ki usi tarah se side mein you can put something jisme run time pe hawa bhar rahi hai and then the boat will come up float
so basically the bumper cars which are covered by so you're saying
bumper,
like that only
cars
it should be inflatable
jo pani mein daudate hain wahi na bumper rides unki baat kar rahe
ho no normal bumper cars It is covered by rubber, right?
I don't know. Rubber, okay.
So basically, you are telling that only, but it should be inflated.
हाँ, because air is a good, it's like ठीक है, काफी density कम होती है, it displaces a lot more mass of water than what mass it actually has. तो उसका है 1 gram mass होगा, but it will inflate it and वो 1000 gram पानी को displace कर देगा. That way. What else is there? Anything you want to add? And always use words like out of line forces. Once you have created to rotate the board, are the out of line forces. Out of line forces. This is in line. This is out of line. Okay. Any questions? Puchna kuch. Puchna hai kuch.
Ek sawal hai. Agar if battery अगर तुमने बैटरी उसके ऊपर नहीं लगाई तो अगर बैटरी ऊपर लगा रही होती तो डूब जाता तो बैटरी भी तो खराब हो जाती तो मतलब बैटरी इसके मतलब कहना क्या बैटरी इसके ऊपर क्यों नहीं लगाई साइड में क्यों लगाई
I think you just answered your own question. If I put it on top, it would sink as the density of the board would be much more.
You can put balloons,
of course.
Yeah, you can put balloons.
That too is already discussed. Any questions?
You want to add anything else? Sure.
Not that I can think of.
Okay. Thank you.